All right, guys, this is gonna be for Luke Combs' new single called One Number Away. And the version that I'm gonna do here is actually their live acoustic version. So I'll post a link to it in the description. I think it sounds a little bit better than the album version, at least in my opinion. So I'll just go ahead and run through a little bit of it, and then we'll go into the lesson. Messed up a little bit on the pre-chorus there, but anyway, let's jump into the lesson. Let me turn this a little bit. There we go. So how this is gonna work is he starts out. If you watch their video, you'll notice he's got his capo on the fourth fret. That's only because his guitar, Rob's guitar, is tuned down a half step. Mine's in standard. So if you're in standard tuning, put your capo on the third fret, it's going to sound exactly like what they're playing. If you're in half step like they are, put it on the fourth fret, chords are all the same, and it'll sound like what they're doing. So he actually starts out with an up strum. So he's raking and just muting the strings with his fret hand over here. So what you're going to do there is you're just going to mute the strings, rake up, and then immediately on the your low E string, the top string, you're going to do third fret with a down pick, second fret with an upstroke. So, and then he hammers into an E minor. So, you notice he's hammering again there on this time just the D string. Goes into an A suspended, so it's like an A minor. You just don't put this finger down yet, but you are going to use it. So what you're doing there is you're hammering. Let me see if I can move the camera to make this a little better. So you're just going to hammer on this first fret. Down strums there, and then you're coming back with an up strum, and you're hitting this third fret on your high E. So, let me move it back so you can see both hands. There you go. All right. So you're just coming back up and doing the third fret and the second fret again. The strum a little bit there. And then when he goes out of the verse, the last line where he says probably playing some may or get lost in your favorite line, he stops on the up strum there, and then Rob goes into it's a some sort of G chord. So basically, you're gonna hold the third fret on your low E, third fret on your A string, second fret on your D string, and then the first fret on your B string. So your chord's gonna sound like that. So, and then the pre-course is. So what he's doing there, he slides the whole chord down by 2 frets. So he does that twice. Chorus is going to be 4 different, well, on the first go around, it's just 4 different chords. So you got a G, and you're holding this whole time for the first pass on the chorus. You're holding both of these bottom strings on the 3rd fret. Those fingers are never going to move, so you can just kind of keep them anchored. So you got the G chord, and then this is, I guess, kind of like a D with an F sharp bass line. So again, your 2 bottom fingers are going to stay on the 3rd frets. Your G, the G string here, you're going to hold the 2nd fret with your middle finger, and then your index finger is going to come up and grab the top string on the 2nd fret. So you got that chord, then it's not like that. The next one's going to be an E minor 7. Again, your 2 bottom fingers stay where they're at, and then you just make an E minor. And then you're going to go into a C add 9. So, 3rd fret on your A string, 2nd fret on your D string, and then of course your 2 bottom fingers stay the same. So that's for the first time through on the course. So it's going to sound like... Second time, he's gonna do the G, this D chord, E minor 7, and he's gonna go back into this G that we used in the pre-chorus. Goes right back into the same chords for the verse. And then when he gets to the bridge, the line that starts, "Will you pick up when I call?" So he starts out with an E minor, and it goes to this same chord that we've been using in the pre-chorus. I think it's like an A. Anyway, so here you go. So I don't think I covered it before. I know I said slide it down, but basically your ring finger is on the 5th fret of your top string. Pinky's on the 5th fret of your A string. Ring finger is on the 4th fret of your D string. And then your index finger is on the 3rd fret of the B. So, basically all he's doing is the E minor, and then this A chord, and then he goes to this G chord, he goes back to the A chord. back into the chorus, and I think he's like saying away there at the end, but it's the same chords. Song, he just ends on E minor, and that's it. Hopefully that helps. I'll leave a link to Luke's version of this in the description. If you have questions about any of the equipment, the guitar, the capo, the tuner, any of that stuff that I'm using, I also have links to all of that stuff in the description. Hope this helps. Thanks for taking the time to watch my video. I hope it helped you learn something. Feel free to check out my other videos. If you liked this video, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more.